Hello students, welcome back to my class. Today I am going to teach class 7th. The subject is English and the sub subject is honeycomb. The topic, today's topic is three questions. So today I am going to teach you honeycomb for class 7th. This is chapter number 1 in your book, and the name of the chapter, the topic is three questions. This is part 1. The chapter is divided into two parts, that's why I will also teach you this chapter into two parts. So let's start with the chapter. So the part number 1 is, the thought came to a certain king that he would never fail if he knew three things. These three things were: what is the right time to begin something, which people should he listen to, what is the most important thing for him to do. There was a certain king, and in the mind of that king there came a thing, there came a question that he would never fail if he knew the three things. And what are those three things? Number 1, the first one is, what is the right time to begin something? The first thing is, what is the right time to begin something? He thought that if he knew the right time of beginning anything, the right time to begin anything, then he would never fail in his life. And the second one was, which people should he listen to? And the second thing was that, who are the people on whom he could trust, whom he listened to? So this was the second thing. And what was the third thing? The third one was, what is the most important thing for him to do? And at the time when he is doing something, what is the most important thing to do at that particular time? And the king thought that if he would know these things, he would never fail in his life. Now let us see the next one. The next paragraph is, the king therefore sent messengers throughout his kingdom promising a large sum of money to anyone who would answer these three questions. For that reason, he sent the messengers all over his country, all over his kingdom, and told those messengers to give the message to his countrymen that if anyone would be able to answer these three questions, he would give that person a big prize. He would give that person a big amount of money. Saying that, he sent his messenger all over the country, all over the kingdom. Next, if there will be any word meaning, you will get the word meaning at my left side in written form. And the next one is, many wise men came to the king, but they all answered his questions differently. A lot of people came to the king's court because they wanted to get the money, because they wanted to get the prize that the king promised. And who would answer these three questions? And those people answered these three questions, but the king was not satisfied with the answer of those persons. Next paragraph. But they all answered his questions differently. But all the people answered his questions differently. No one gave, here can say, all the persons give the answer differently. There was not a single person who could satisfy the king. Now then, in next paragraph it is given, in reply to the first question, some said the king must prepare timetable and then follow it strictly. Only in this way, they said, could he do everything at its proper time. Others said that it was impossible to decide in advance the right time for doing something. In reply to the first question is, what is the right time to begin something? The question is, what is the right time to begin something? And in reply, in answer to the first question, some said the king must prepare a timetable. There must be a timetable that the king should follow that timetable and then follow it strictly, and the king should follow that timetable strictly. And only in this way, they said, could he do everything at its proper time. And they also told that only by following the timetable, the king could do the things at the proper time. And others said that it was impossible to decide in advance the right time for doing something. There were also few people who told the king that it is not possible, it is not possible to, you can say, plan for something to do. It is not possible. Others said that it was impossible to decide in advance the right time for doing something. It is not possible in advance to plan for something to do. And the king should notice all that was going on. And at that time, the king was noticing all the things that were going on at that time. Avoid foolish pleasures. Some people told him that avoid foolish pleasure. You don't try to be pleased on the foolish things, and always do what you were seem necessary at that time, and you should try to always do the things that is that seems you necessary to do. Next, yet others said that the king needed a council of wise men who would help him at the proper time. Act at the proper time. Council, a group of people who advises the persons who make the rules of a country. So the some people, at others said that the king needed a council of wise men. Some advised the king to prepare a council of wise men. You prepare a council, and in that council you select the wise men of the country, and who would help him act in the proper time. Those person can help the king to do the things at proper time. And this was because one man would find it impossible to decide correctly without help from others the right time for every action. They also told that one person can't be successful for preparing the time. If there would be many people and they will decide to do something and they will advise the king, then the king can find out the best time for doing, for starting, for beginning anything. So one man would find it impossible to decide correctly. For one man, it would be impossible to decide what is the correct time to begin something, and without help from others, the right time or every action. Means without the help of anybody, a single person can't do these things. So the king must have wise men, a council of wise men. This was the advice of few people. Next, but then others said that there were some things which could be urgent. These things could not wait for the decision of the council. But there were others who told that there were some things which could be urgent. There may be some urgent situation. At that time, the king would not be able to call the council of wise men. At that time, what would the king do? These things could not wait for the decision of the council, and urgent things can't wait for the decision of the council. So council will not help the king, and in order to decide the right time for doing something, it is necessary to look into the future. For It is given in order to decide the right time, one must have to look into the future. He must try to look into the future that he can find the difficulties that the king can could find the difficulties that he could face in future. And only magicians could do that. The king therefore would have to go to magicians. And the people told him that, those kinds of people told him that, and only magicians could do that. Only magicians could do that. Only magicians could see into the future. That's why the king should consult the magicians. The king should go to the magicians. Next, in their answers to the second question, some said that the people most necessary to the king were his counselors. Others said the priests. A few others chose the doctors, and eight others said that his soldiers were the most necessary. And in answer to the second question, in reply to the second question was, which people should he listen to? The question was, which people should he listen to? Some people answered, some people replied that in their answer to the second question, some said that the people most necessary to the king were his counselors. They told that the people who are most necessary for the king are counselors. Counselors, the member of the council, are the counselors. Others said the priests. But there were some other people who told that counselors are not important for the king, but the priests. They told that priests are more important than the counselor. So he should try to listen to the priest. Some told he should try to listen to the counselor. Some people told the king he should try to listen to the priests. And a few others choose the doctors. And there were a few other people who choose the doctor, who told the doctor, who told the king he should listen to the doctor. And eight others said that his soldiers were the most necessary. And there were also few people who advised the king to listen to his soldiers, because his soldiers are more important than any other person. So in answer to the second questions, these were the things that the king got from the people. But he was not satisfied. He was not satisfied with these answers. And to the third question, some said science, others choose fighting, and yet others religious worship. And for the answer of the third question was, what is the most important thing for him to do? The question was, what is the most important thing for the king to do? Some people replied that for the third question, some said science. And others said fighting. Some other people answered fighting, and yet others religious worship. And there were some other people who told the king that the answer is religious worship. The king should try to go towards the religion. As the answers to his questions were so different, the king was not satisfied and gave no reward. As the answers of the questions were so varied, there was not a single answer. There were different kinds of answers. That's why the king was worried. The king was not satisfied with those answers. That's why he did not reward. He did not give the reward to anyone. Instead, he decided to seek the advice of a certain hermit. He decided to go and ask the advice of a hermit. There was a famous hermit. And hermit is a person who is living lonely at some places. A person who lives alone and leads a simple life is called the hermit. Certain hermit who was widely known for his wisdom, because that hermit was widely known for his wisdom. That was a wise hermit. That's why the king decided to go to the towards the hermit and ask the answer of his three questions. Next, the hermit lived in a wood which he never left. He saw no one but simple people, and so the king put on ordinary clothes. Before he reached the hermit's hut, the king left his horse with his bodyguard and went on alone. The hermit lived in a wood. Wood is used in literature for the small forest. The hermit lived in a forest. There was a small forest in that country, and in that forest the hermit lived, and he never left that forest. And he saw no one but simple people. The hermit saw no one but simple people, means he saw only simple people, and he didn't know any more about the world. Simple people. And so the king put on ordinary clothes, and that was the reason that the king also put the ordinary clothes. And before he reached the hermit's hut, the king left his horse with his bodyguard. Before he reached the hermit's hut, he left his horse with his bodyguard. That hermit couldn't understand that he is a king, and went on alone. And from that place he went towards the hermit's hut alone. As the king came near the hermit's hut, he saw the hermit digging the ground in front of his hut. He greeted the king and continued digging. The hermit was old and weak, and as he walked he breathed heavily. As the king came near the hermit's hut, when the king came near the hermit's hut, at that time he saw the hermit digging the ground. At that time he saw that the hermit was digging the ground. Dig karna, khudai karna, jisko hum kehte hain. Digging the ground. Where? In front of his hut. The hermit was digging the ground in front of his hut in the forest. And he greeted the king and continued digging. He greeted, greet, welcomed, here you can say. He welcomed the king and continued his work. Continued his work, the work of digging the ground. The hermit was old and weak, and as he worked, he breathed heavily. The hermit was very old and weak. That's why when he was trying to dig the ground, he breathed heavily. जब भी जो है, चूँकि हर्मिट बहुत बूढ़ा था, इससे जब भी खुदाई करता था तो क्या, बहुत तेजी से सांसें लेता था. बिकॉज द हर्मिट वॉज ओल्ड एंड वीक. द किंग वेंट अप टू द हर्मिट एंड सेड, आई हैव कम टू यू वाइज हर्मिट टू आस्क यू टू द आंसर्स थ्री क्वेश्चंस. द किंग वेंट अप टू द हर्मिट एंड सेड. द किंग वेंट टूवर्ड्स द हर्मिट एंड ही सेड टू द हर्मिट, I have come to you, wise hermit, to ask you to answer three questions. I have three questions, and I want the answers of those three questions. That's why, that is the reason, that's why I came to you. You, wise hermit, to ask you to answer three questions. How can I learn to do the right thing at the right time? The first question is, how can I learn to do the right thing at the right time? The second question is, who are the people I need most? And the third question is, and what affairs, you can say business, work, what are the works, what are the business are the most important? What are the most important business, what are the most important work for me? These are the three questions, and I want to get the answer of these three questions. Now, next one. The hermit listened to the king but did not speak. He went on digging. The hermit listened to the king, but he didn't answer the king. He continued his work of digging the ground. He didn't answer the king. You are tired, said the king. On saying that, the king said to the hermit, You are tired. Let me take the shade and walk in your place. Shade, Hindi में जिसको कुदाल हम लोग कहते हैं. Let me take your shade and dig the ground. means you give me your shed, I will dig your ground. Thanks, said the hermit, giving the king his spade. Then he sat down on the ground. The hermit said thanks to the king, and he gave his spade to the king and said thank you to him. Then he sat down on the ground, and after that he sat down on the ground. Now next one, when the king had dug two beds, he stopped and repeated his questions. When the king had dug two beds, beds here used for a small part of the ground, means small patches of ground for plants, जिसको हिंदी में हम लोग क्यारियाँ कहते हैं, छोटे छोटे जो है खेतों में जो है क्यारियाँ जो बनाते हैं उसी को beds कहते हैं. When the king had dug two beds, when the king had dug two beds, two patches of the ground, he stopped and repeated his question. He stopped at that time and he once again repeated his questions. And he told the hermit to give the answer of those questions. The hermit gave no answer, but he stood up. He didn't answer the king. Stretching out his hand for the spade and said, now you rest and let me work. He stretched out his hand for the spade. He told the king to give him the spade that he can dig the ground. And he told the king to rest for some time, because now the king was, you can say, because the king was wants to get the rest. So for the spade, and he said, now you rest and let me work. Because the king was tired, that's why he had taken the spade from the king and told him to take some rest. But the king did not give him the spade and continued to dig. But the king did not give him the spade and he continued to dig the ground. He continued digging the ground and he did not give the spade to the hermit. 1 hour passed, then another. The sun went down behind the trees, and at last the king struck the spade into the ground and said, I came to you, wise man, for an answer to my questions. If you can give me no answer, tell me so, and I will return home. 1 hour passed, after 1 hour, 2 hour passed, like that, whole day was passed. The sun went down behind the trees, and the sun went down behind the trees, means now it was the time of the evening. And at last the king struck the ground spade, struck, you can say, to sit. He set the spade into the ground and said, and he said to the hermit, I came to you, wise man, for an answer to my questions. I came, wise man, for the answers of my questions. I have questions and I need the answer of those questions. And if you can give me no answer, tell me so, and I will return home. If you are not able to give the answer of my questions, you tell me so. You tell me that you are not able to give the answer of my questions. Then I will return back to my home. And I will return home. If you are not able to give the answer, tell me, I will return back to my home. I will not, you can say, disturb you. Here comes someone running, said the hermit. On that, hermit said that, here comes someone running. Someone is coming towards us running. See, someone is coming. On the dialogue of the hermit, the first stage, the first part of the story is completed. I will complete the second part of the story in the next class. In this part, we have also question. For example, it is given, why did the king want to know the answer to three questions? The king wanted to know the answers of the three questions because he thought that he would never fail to do anything. He would never fail if he knew the answers of these three questions. And one more question is MCQ. Messengers were sent throughout the kingdom. What is the correct, mark the correct one? To fetch wise men, to find answer to the questions, to look for the wise hermit, to announce a reward for those who could answer the questions. So the correct option is to announce a reward for those who could answer the questions. So these two questions are given, two comprehension checks are given in your part one. So for today, my class is over. Thank you. Have a nice day.